Hello students, in the earlier video of some basic concept of chemistry, we have completed the Gay-Lussac's law of gaseous volume, Dalton's atomic theory, modified form of Dalton's atomic theory. In this video, we are going to study the Avogadro's hypothesis. According to Dalton's atomic theory, atom is the smallest particle which is involved in the chemical reaction. It was the fundamental particle, and whenever the ratio is represented, it represented in the terms of atoms. It means in this case, whenever the chemical reaction is taking place by the atoms, then this is bearing a simple whole number ratio. So this was the difference between the Gay-Lussac's law. Gay-Lussac's law was represented for the gaseous, when the gases are reacting in terms of volumes. So this volume is bearing a simple whole number ratio, whereas in the case of Dalton's atomic theory, the reaction is taking place by the atoms, and whenever the atom react with one another and forming compound atoms, which was later named as molecules, it is bearing a simple whole number ratio with respect to atoms. So later a new scientist came forward whose name was Berzelius. So he given the hypothesis which is later named as Berzelius hypothesis, which correlated both these two theories, that is Gay-Lussac's law of gaseous volume and Dalton's atomic theory. He correlated both these theories and put forward the generalization on the basis of the correlation. According to Berzelius hypothesis, equal volume of all gases at similar condition of temperature and pressure consisting of equal number of atoms. So by this hypothesis, he correlated Gay-Lussac's law with Dalton's atomic theory. So let's see how Berzelius correlated these two laws in his generalization on the basis of experiment. So in the case of when hydrogen is reacted with chlorine, there is a formation of two volumes of HCl is taking place. So all these are gases. So in this case, Gay-Lussac's law is applied. So on the basis of Gay-Lussac's law, whenever the gases react with each other, they always do so with respect to volume, and this volume is always bearing a simple whole number ratio. So in this case, all these reactants and products are gaseous state. It means one volume of hydrogen is reacting with the one volume of chlorine to form two volume of HCl. So this is on the basis of Gay-Lussac's law. So on the basis of Berzelius hypothesis. So on the basis of Berzelius hypothesis, equal volume of all gases in similar condition of temperature and pressure consisting of equal number of atoms. It means n atoms of hydrogen react with n atoms of chlorine to form 2n compound atoms of HCl. Compound atoms were later named as molecule. So for the formation of a single compound atom, single molecule, we have to divide all the side by 2n. So on dividing all the side by 2n, so what is happening in this case? Half atom of hydrogen combine with the half atom of chlorine to form one compound atom of HCl, to form single HCl molecule, because in the case of HCl molecule, there is one atom of hydrogen and one atom of chlorine. So for the formation of single HCl molecule, we require one atom of hydrogen and one atom of chlorine to form one compound atom of HCl. But this Berzelius hypothesis was later discarded because it is contradicting with Dalton's atomic theory. According to Dalton's atomic theory, atom was the smallest particle which is taking part in the chemical reaction, and atom is indivisible. It means atom cannot be divided. But in the case of Berzelius hypothesis, when he was trying to correlate the volume of gas with the atom, then he represented the atom in the form of fraction, which is not possible. According to Dalton's atomic theory, atom cannot be divided, whereas in the case of Berzelius hypothesis, atom was represented in half. It means atom is presented in divisible form. It means atom is represented in half form, which cannot be possible as in the case of Dalton's atomic theory. So this theory was later discarded. Later, a new scientist came whose name was Avogadro's. He was an Italian scientist. So on the basis of his observation, he clearly observed the Berzelius hypothesis. And on the basis of his observation, he differentiated the ultimate particle, which is forming atoms and molecule. He said that both atoms and molecule having different characteristic. As in the case of atom, atom is a smallest particle which is taking part in the chemical reaction, but atom may or may not be capable of independent existence. Whereas in the case of molecule, molecule is capable of independent existence. So he differentiate the ultimate particle, that is atoms and molecules, with each other. So on the basis of his observation, he correlated the volume of a gas with molecule, not with atoms, because molecule can exist independently. So on the basis of Avogadro's hypothesis, what is happening? In this case, similar case, when we take hydrogen and it is reacting with the chlorine, there is a formation of HCl is taking place. So on balancing the equation, 2 volume of HCl will be formed. So when we represent this reaction in the form of volume, it is representing Gay-Lussac's law. 1 volume of hydrogen is reacting with the 1 volume of chlorine to form 2 volume of HCl. So this is on the basis of Gay-Lussac's law, in which the gases are reacting with each other in respect to volume. So on the basis of Avogadro, equal volume of all gases consisting of equal number of molecule in similar condition of temperature and pressure. So this is the improvised form. In the case of Berzelius, equal volume of all gases consisting of equal number of atoms in similar condition of temperature and pressure. N molecules of hydrogen is reacting with N molecule of chlorine to form 2N molecules of HCl. For the formation of single molecule of HCl, we divide all the side by 2N. So on dividing all sides by 2N, so what is happening in this case? It means half molecule of hydrogen is reacting with the half molecule of chlorine to form 1 molecule of HCl. It means in the case of HCl, hydrogen chloride, there is a single atom of hydrogen and a single atom of chlorine. For that, we have to react half molecule of hydrogen with half molecule of chlorine. So this is not contradicting with Dalton's atomic theory, because in the case of molecule, molecule is made up of 2 or more atoms. So molecule can be divided because it is made up of 2 or more atoms, not a single atom. So it is not contradicting with the Dalton's atomic theory. In this case, volume of gases is related with the molecules, and molecule can be divided because it is made up of 2 or more atoms, not a single atom. So this Avogadro hypothesis was accepted. So Avogadro hypothesis successfully correlated the Gay-Lussac's law with the Dalton's atomic theory. So there are many applications of Avogadro's hypothesis. So let's see what are the application of Avogadro's hypothesis. So let's start the application of Avogadro's hypothesis. First application of Avogadro hypothesis was that he helped in determining the atomicity of elementary gases. So what is atomicity? Atomicity is the number of atoms of same element which are present in the single molecule of elementary gas. Example, in the case of oxygen, oxygen is having 2 atoms of oxygen. So the atomicity of oxygen molecule is 2, because in the case of oxygen molecule, there are 2 atoms of oxygen are present. Whereas in the ozone, ozone having formula O3, it means 3 atoms of oxygen are present in the single molecule of ozone. So the atomicity of ozone is 3. Similarly, in the case of phosphorus, single molecule of phosphorus is made up of four atoms of phosphorus. So the atomicity of phosphorus is 4. So the atomicity of phosphorus is 4. Similarly, in the case of sulfur, single molecule of sulfur is consisting of 8 atoms of sulfur. So the atomicity of sulfur is 8. Similarly, in the case of nitrogen, atomicity of nitrogen in the single molecule of nitrogen is 2. Similarly, in the case of chlorine, single molecule of chlorine is consisting of 2 atoms of chlorine. So this is atomicity. So how this atomicity was calculated, how this atomicity was derived? Example, in the case of hydrogen, when hydrogen is reacting with oxygen, it is forming water. So on balancing the equation, we know that in this case, if the water is present in the vapor state, it means it is following Gay-Lussac's law. It means all the reactants and products are in the gaseous state. So in this case, 2 volume of hydrogen will be taken, which react with the 1 volume of oxygen. So there is a formation of 2 volumes of H2O will take place. It means in this case, 2 volume of hydrogen will be taken, which react with the 1 volume of oxygen. So it will form 2 volume of water vapor. So if we represent this hypothesis, this Gay-Lussac's law, in terms of molecules, which is Avogadro's hypothesis, so on relation with the molecule, we know that equal volume of all gases in similar condition of temperature and pressure consisting of equal molecules. This is Avogadro's hypothesis. It means 2 molecules of hydrogen react with the 1 molecule of oxygen to form 2 molecules of H2O. So on simplification, for formation of single molecule of H2O, we have to divide all the side by 2. So in this case, what is happening? In this case, 1 molecule of hydrogen will react with the 1/2 molecule of oxygen to form single molecule of H2O. So in this case, it means in the case of H2O, single molecule of H2O, there is 1 atom of oxygen and 2 atoms of hydrogen in the formula. It means 1/2 molecule of oxygen is having 1 atom of oxygen, then 1 molecule of oxygen is having 2 atoms of oxygen. It means the atomicity of oxygen molecule is 2. Because in this case, in the single molecule of H2O, there is only 1 atom of oxygen is present. And for the formation of single molecule of H2O, how much of oxygen is required? Only 1/2. 1/2 molecule of oxygen is equal to 1 atom of oxygen. Then 1 molecule of oxygen will be equal to 2 atoms. So the atomicity of oxygen is 2. Second application of Avogadro's law is the relationship between the vapor density of gas and molecular mass of the gas. So in this case, vapor density of gas is represented in terms of formula, which is given as density of a particular gas divided by density of hydrogen gas. This can be represented in the terms of mass of volume. So in this case, mass of certain volume of a gas divided by mass of same volume of hydrogen gas. So both the volumes are represented in STP, that is standard temperature and pressure. So this formula can also be related with respect to molecules, because as in the case of Avogadro's law, similar volume of all gases consisting of a similar number of molecules. So in this case, volume can be correlated with the molecules. So in this case, this formula can also be represented as mass of n molecules of gas divided by mass of n hydrogen molecule. So we can also relate this formula with the mass of single molecule. So in this case, mass of one molecule of gas divided by mass of one molecule of hydrogen. We know that one molecule of hydrogen is having two atoms. It means the atomicity of hydrogen is 2. In this case, there are 2 atoms of hydrogen are present. So the atomicity of hydrogen molecule is 2, which can be represented as 2 in the further. So this formula can be represented in this case also. So in this case, the mass of one mole of gas is divided by 2, which is representing the atomicity of hydrogen. So in this case, single molecule of gas, single molecule of particular gas can also be represented in the form of molecular mass. The mass of single molecule of gas can also be represented in the form of molecular mass. So the formula becomes molecular mass. So the formula of vapor density is equal to molecular mass divided by 2. So this is a relative gas density. Next application of Avogadro's hypothesis is that it helps in determining the relationship between the mass of the gas and its volume. So let's see how this relationship is obtained. We know that vapor density is equal to molecular mass divided by atomicity of hydrogen, which is 2. Molecular mass is equal to 2 into vapor density. We have studied earlier the formula of vapor density. So in respect to volume, the formula of vapor density is represented as 2 into, we know that the mass of certain volume of particular gas divided by mass of same volume of hydrogen gas. So both the masses of particular volume is represented in STP, that is standard temperature and pressure. Further, if we represent this volume in 1 liter, so what is happening in this case? The mass of 1 liter of particular gas divided by mass of 1 liter of hydrogen gas. So mass of 1 liter of hydrogen gas. So in this case, the gas is represented. So we can find out the mass of 1 liter of hydrogen gas, which after calculation is obtained is having value 0.089. So this is the mass of 1 liter of hydrogen gas is having value 0.089 grams. So what is the formula of molecular mass which is obtained? Molecular mass equal to 2 into mass of 1 liter of gas divided by the mass of 1 liter of hydrogen gas is 0.089 gram. So on solving this problem, when we divide 2 by 0.089, which is coming after calculation is 22.4. And this will be written as it is into mass of 1 liter of gas. This is equal to molecular mass. This molecular mass can be represented as mass of 22.4 liter of gas at STP. It means the 22.4 liter of gas at STP is equivalent to the molecular mass, which is expressed in grams. So this mass is known as gram molecular mass. It means 22.4 liter of any gas at STP, that is standard temperature and pressure, is equivalent to molecular mass, is equivalent to molecular mass, which is represented in the form of grams. So this molecular mass is known as gram molecular mass.